So today we're going to talk about something that seems to be of broad interest to those raising honeybees, gardening, or flying drones. And in my past videos, I've shown a screen often, which is the display for the Acurite 5-in-1 Pro Plus weather sensor. This is another weather sensor that I've purchased, and I'll be operating two of these. And this one's going to go into my bee yard, so I'll know exactly what's going on at 5 foot height, right where the bees are exposed to sun, wind, rain, and all the elements. So what we're showing here is the display on the left. We have the outdoor weather sensor, 5-in-1 Pro Plus, which is model 06014, and even a lightning detector, which is kind of cool to have if you're going to be outside. This is the stamp on the outdoor portion, and it also has solar panels on it, two of them. My old unit only had one. The solar panels are used just to generate energy to keep a fan going inside. So on a nice hot day, you want to make sure that the temperature reading is accurate, so it has its own fan inside. We also have a wind speed anemometer here, and that looks pretty much unchanged from previous models. I've been using these for years. This is the rain basin, and there's a little catch screen there that prevents leaves and debris from getting down into your rain meter, which really is just a little teeter-totter that's got reservoirs in it. And it comes with a little bubble leveler on top, so when you're installing it, you'll be able to make sure that it's perfectly level. And what else do we have? Comes with a little mast mount here. If you want it to be taller and you don't have something to screw it to, you can use a 3/4-inch galvanized pipe, according to them in the instruction manual. All the screws are here. And this is the bottom side of it. It has batteries, and you're not supposed to use rechargeable batteries, but I do the lithium rechargeable batteries because I'm kind of a renegade, I guess. It comes with the little stop installed to make sure that the rain meter doesn't teeter-totter back and forth in transit. So you just pull that tape off and a little piece of plastic comes out, and there it is, ready to run. And here I used Amazon rechargeable AA basics. Remember, it takes four of them. They don't want you to use rechargeables, but that's what I've been using in my units for over 2 years, so they seem to work fine. There's also a adjustment to calibrate the rainfall. There are complete detailed instructions inside the owner's manual showing you exactly how to do that, and it involves holding a cup of water and dripping it in there so the rain gauge will read accurately. And here's the look at the bottom, the whole thing. Now there is a control inside. Before I put those batteries, I probably should have given you greater detail on that, but it has A, B, or C. I set this to the C channel because I have more than one of these out there. I have another one on A, and I want them to read the correct indicator. Now south is marked right on top, and that's so that the solar panels face south, which exploits the sunlight. It also has to point specifically south because that's your wind direction indicator that's going to be feeding back to your display unit. And the display unit, and here it is just sitting on the mast controller there. If you have that mast and you install that and that's level, you don't have to worry about leveling it up once you install the indicator itself. And again, here's the display, and it just has the paper pieces on it. Pull those off so you can see what that looks like before you put power to it. Nice glossy glass display that you can hang on the wall or set on a table. You don't need batteries, but if you have a power outage, you're going to lose all your data, so I recommend installing batteries. And if you look closely here, you also have the ABC setting. I set it to C again because that has to match the outside sensor unit. And the bottom here down below is the reset button, so it goes to all the factory settings if you want to get rid of your history. With the back panel pulled off, it shows your DC plug location and that USB connector. There is software to download so that you can record all your data and get alerts for severe weather, winds, and heavy rains. Again, AA basic rechargeable batteries. These are high performance batteries. They tell you again not to use them because they're rechargeable, but I do anyway and they seem to work fine. And of course the AC adapter is plugged in. And here's the back enclosure in place. Again, hang it on the wall or put it right on your windowsill or something like that. Don't put it in direct sunlight. Don't put it next to a heater and so on, because of course it's recording indoor temperature and humidity as well. You'll notice that the readout, 59 to 61 degrees, that's because both of these units are actually sitting inside side by side, so there's even a disparity between the two right there. Another thing I'm going to cover is the lightning detector. The lightning detector is pretty cool. You can carry it around with you. Great safety gadget, and it reads lightning strikes within 25 miles of your location. So if you're an outdoor person, I'm a photographer, I don't want tripods and metal gear sitting outside when lightning comes in. I don't want to get any of my equipment hit. If you're a boater, a fisherman, whatever, that's going to be important to you. And I thought I would check the accuracy of the temperature gauge on this indoor unit. And the outdoor unit, of course, are both inside, and they're reading 59. The calibrated thermometer is reading 58.3. So it's about a degree off. They're reading a little hotter than it actually is. And we both have indoor and outdoor at 59. And again, that's because the weather sensor's inside and the display is also inside. So here it is. I'm just showing the wind indicator here, wind direction indicator. If you don't level this up just right and you have low winds, it's going to affect wind direction sensing there. The other thing is at the bottom of the display, it shows history. And so it'll show the history of the highest rainfall, the coldest temperatures, the hottest temperatures, the highest wind speed. And you have opportunities to select here. And you notice there's a set button in the middle. A cool thing that came with this display, other than my older ones, is that it shows the signal strength to the left there, and it also shows the outdoor sensor's battery level. So in the past, I just went out there and changed them routinely, but now I can look to see if it's up to speed and if the battery's still good. So that's cool. Notice here in the center left slightly, it says learning. This thing is going to run for about a week and collect data about barometric pressure and things like that, and then ultimately it will be able to predict kind of where your weather is headed. So it's kind of its own forecast system also. Notice here at the bottom it has average and peak. It says 4 and 12, so the average wind speed is 4. The peak wind speed, since it's been running, is 12. Now we're taking a close look at this lightning detector. The lightning detector is pretty cool. This all came as a bundle to me, and I did purchase it on Amazon. I'll put the link to the exact unit that I bought later on in the description for this video. And again, that uses AAA batteries. I don't know if they want you to use rechargeables, but I used, again, Amazon Basics rechargeable batteries. And this is with the back cover back in place. And then there's, of course, a belt clip that comes with it. And the belt clip has the instructions clearly on it, so you can change modes. If you turn it on and off, I'll go through that and show you and let you listen to what the beeps are like. When there is a lightning strike, the alarm is pretty good. And I think it's neat to just be aware of what's going on. In the bottom, that little gap there, you could actually have a lanyard and carry this around your neck. So let's turn it on. And now it's listening, so it's ready to record lightning strikes. Now if you turn it off and turn it back on again, it automatically goes to its normal outdoor high sensitivity mode. And that's pretty good. But if you're inside, you can get some false readings. You can walk up to a light switch and flip the switch with this thing, and it will read a lightning strike. So if you're inside your home, you want to put it in the indoor mode, which displays here indoor. And that will cut out a lot of those false readings. You can even open a refrigerator door or stand next to a fluorescent light on or off and get that thing to trigger. Microwave ovens, things like that as well. So there it is, ready and listening again. So, I wish I had a lightning storm. I would go out there and record it for you. And when it's in the indoor mode, it shows indoors just like this. You want to take it out of the indoor mode and put it to the outdoor mode again. You just turn it off and back on, and it goes to that default setting. You can also silence it by holding that illumination button for a few seconds, 5 seconds, I believe, and it goes silent for 60 minutes. So again, we're back to the display, and I have corrected the date and time setting. So now it's December 6th of 2017, 9:06 a.m. And we've got the history that it collected overnight. And I did not set the clock yesterday, so, you know, it's wrong. It's reading January, whatever. So that's incorrect. And I could reset that by pushing the button on the back, which is underneath the settings button. and that will reset all the factory defaults on it, and you can go from there, clear the memory. So now it's 25 degrees Fahrenheit outside. I have a 5 mile an hour wind condition, but it peaked, as you can see, at 17 miles an hour, and the average is 7 miles an hour. Indoor outdoor humidity, everything is on here. These things are pretty cool. If you want to know the weather, again, it says it's learning. If you want to know weather conditions, put one of these outside, put this unit at 5 feet or higher. This one is next to my bee yard, as I mentioned, and it's going to let me know from inside exactly what's going on with my bees. I know if I hit 50 degrees or so, that my bees will be flying right there, and I can record this data, upload it onto my computer, and keep a database of all the weather conditions for apiary throughout the year. Thanks for watching. I hope you learned something from this. I hope you check out your own weather station. These things are really not that expensive. Happy beekeeping, and fly your drones safe and keep them out of the air when your wind conditions are high.